Hi and welcome. Today we are at the forest lake. We are testing balance pilks. Pekko Leino from Kalapele sent me new lures last week actually. Now it's already almost end of the season. The ice is gonna go sugar ice, so I need to be really careful what I'm doing now today. We're gonna test the new lures, new rods, and hopefully the perches are biting. So let's see how it goes. Yeah, it's booming quite nice. So, shall we test the ice?
Yeah, let's leave the pulkas here. We are still at the shoreline. So here the ice is still all the way to the bottom, 10 centimeters or something.
Yeah.
Let's test
it. Yep. Shall I drill here? Took them out once, then they are not going anymore. So, new lures, new rods. This is the new rod, and so this is the new rod what I got, and we're gonna start. Which one was my box?
That is your box.
This one, and now we're gonna try the new lures. I'm gonna go with this super muikko. This is super vendens. And it was already in my finger. How nice. This is nice and white, black on the top. There. And then I'm gonna take my old rod. I'm gonna put the completely something different on this one. So if there's a fish what doesn't want to bite this, then I will have something different. I think I'll try this orange belly one. Same kind of lure, but with the orange belly. There. So first goes this. Yeah, there is a fish. There. First one up. This is size of Mrs. Cat. Another one. Another one, wait. Don't drill. Usually this drilling is carrying the big fishes away. And now you can also see what I'm doing. I'm lifting up the lure slowly. And maybe I'm giving a couple wiggles. Usually this works for a big perch. Perch. So that was a nice teaser. Yeah. This kind of stuff happens all the time. The fish came out from nowhere, so I didn't have any time to put the recordings on. Yep. Oho!
Yeah, I said so. It's big.
Really nice.
Yep. I'm guessing 500-600 grams.
Yeah.
And the smaller ones maybe 150-200.
That's awesome. Really nice.
Yeah, we have a nice dinner.
Alright, and a couple of these lures now, what I'm gonna test. This. So a little bit of maybe gray on the back and nice shimmering side. And now actually I'm gonna use it with this rod because I like this rod. I could also use that kehivapa, but that's kind of slightly a bit too big for the these small lures, and I really like this. This also is one of my favorites. This has really nice side and bluish color. So, let's see how it goes with this one. Yes.
Nice, nice.
Yeah. Moving nicely here. This kind of nice hogs, really nice. Oh yeah, 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 yeah. And a new one. right, couple up with this one. Gonna change. Now I'm gonna try this with the flake. This was a good one. So now goes this with the flakes. There. Let's see what happens. It's so nice weather here. Bit cold wind though. And one person was asking from me, like, what do I need to start ice fishing? I want to go on the ice as well. Like I said earlier, you need only drill, rod, any kind of rod. I'm using at the moment this kind of quite stiff rod for this balance pilk. Of course, lines, lure, and that's about it. When you're using a balance pilk, you don't even need a maggots. You just drill a hole, put it there, start fishing. And by the way, how do you fish with these full lead ones? I'm using this rod, and only what I need to do is this kind of move. Nothing else. And just wait. Okay, if you have a sonar, you can see, or I can see, it's 3.4 meters water here. I put it 1 meter below the ice. So it's basically hanging 2 meters from the bottom. And when the fishes are going in the bottom of the lake, usually they're going there, and they can see far away when that balance jig is swimming there. So they will of course come close and look at it, what's going on. And now when I have a sonar, I can see what I need to do to make the fish bite. So when I can see the fish is coming from the bottom, and if the line is really steep, it usually means like, okay, it's gonna bite it, inhale the whole lure immediately. But if it's coming a bit slower or not having so steep angle, maybe I need to move or do a little tricks or wiggles or something, or maybe I lift a bit and wiggle at the same time. That usually works for me. And I think, so basically, how I'm using this, wrist move, yanking, not all the time, maybe every 10 seconds or something, sometimes faster, sometimes slower, and then looking from the sonar if there is anything. This is like basically just trying to get the fish close by. So now it has been working. I haven't usually even needed to start lifting this, and I have already gotten a lot of fish. So that's how it works for me. Hopefully it works for you. I'm trying to angle my camera so you can see what's happening in my sonar. There. One more. Thank you.
Nice. That didn't sound good.
No, it hooked me up with the Kesteli. Kesteli got stuck in my finger. Hence my ow, ow, ow.
Too long. Is it coming?
This bit to the ass of the Kesteli.
There's a lot of now, wait a bit. I'll record. Big swarm. Here. Oh.
Now there's a fish coming up. It was there. Was it biting again? Ay, irti. Is it still coming? Yeah, it is. Ah, the whole sonar sensor came. Hey. Yep. Yeah, it was gonna... Two times already... visiting there and saying like, bang on the lure. But now on the... third time. That goes back. Nice perch. Really nice. Fast stunning. And float out, because I'm gonna make a fillet out from these fishes. And I want perch fillet to be nice and white instead of bloody. I'm putting a bit ice on here. So they stay nice and cool. Yes. Yeah. So they are moving nicely here. Middle hook. Yes. Oh, damn. Hold this.
That has to be 500 grams.
Yeah. And hold this. And here we lined up the biggest fishes. The biggest ones were 600 grams and the smaller ones was 300 plus. We were hoping for enough perch for a meal, but it seemed we got a bit more what we asked for. Several meals.
Rita is here fishing with Kesseli. How is it going?
It's going very well. I filled a bag with fish behind there.
Oh, there it is. It's gonna nice spring weather. Every time when it's like clear and nice and sunny, it's of course blowing like maniac. And plus on that, ice is banging or booming, cracking, making those nice bass echo sounds, and the perch is not liking it so much. But at least we have gotten some fishes now, and it's been a good trip this far. I think that was it. Thanks for watching. There's a huge storm cloud coming on us. I think we're gonna walk and head to our car and then head to home. Next time I'm gonna put something else because I'm not sure are these ices anymore good, how long. Because it's soon really, really dangerous to move on this. And I really don't want to kill myself yet. So I bought myself a new reel and a rod for sea trout fishing. So that might be I will be doing some videos about that. So see you next time. Have a good one and remember to subscribe. Bye bye. Yeah, this kind of nice storm.
This is our cube.